Hello you guys and welcome to my channel. I'm so excited to have you here. Thank you guys for continuing to send me your MLM horror stories. Let's just get straight the freak into it. First MLM horror story we are going to read says, my story isn't too much of a horror story, but just a different outlook. My name is Alicia and I was a Jamberry consultant. My mom found the company and my sister and I decided to become consultants and our mom paid for the starter kit returned for us, promising to try and make it work. We had a launch party and actually made a sale to every person there with making a good paycheck. I never thought of it as a pyramid scheme because we weren't actively recruiting and we were making money by selling products. A few months in, they had a $1,500 incentive for recruitment and my upline kept telling me to get more people on my team to earn more than I was just by selling. I didn't want to recruit, so I kind of just stopped doing stuff altogether. Then a few months after Jamberry went bankrupt, the company went to another company called M Global/Benu. I haven't heard of that. They bought the inventory and grandfathered all the consultants into the company, but never really got us any info. It was so weird and really sketchy. It was health and wellness, which wasn't anything I was interested in. Calling and canceling was a headache because I was technically a Jamberry consultant, not a Benu. I literally don't know how to pronounce it. And I am just done with all of these things. I know this isn't as crazy as some, but it's all the same. Recruitment and sell stuff you aren't certified in. So shout out to this person because they do bring up a good point that like in the end, it's all the same. And even if you are someone that in the moment, you know, what you're doing is just selling products or whatever it is, there's going to come a time where you are, I don't want to say forced to recruit, but incentivized. That's why I always use that word. If you are going to want to recruit, because that is what's going to be incentivized. Because it's weird, right? That there's never any incentives for signing people up because this person said that in a few months they had a $1,500 recruitment incentive. That's like a lot of money to a lot of people. Like if I could get an extra $1,500 this month, I'd be like, tell me how. If I was this person, like tell me how I can get myself $1,500 more. So I know that to a lot of people, when they are told that, they are going to feel like they want to recruit people and then they are going to get themselves into it. You know, I'm glad that she was able to get out. I've never really gone into Jamberry or anything like that. So I am a little bit curious about it because I've never heard of Global Benu either. So it's weird that they like bought the inventory and consultants were grandfathered in, but I am glad that she ended up getting out and it does end up being the same. Like she says, you either sell products you're not certified in or you're not educated in, like hair care companies, you're probably not a hairstylist or someone who's been in that realm for long. Then when it comes to nails, you're probably not a nail tech or anything like that. When it comes to beach body or any wellness MLM, you're probably not certified in health and wellness. So most of these MLMs, you either sell products that you're not certified or trained in or educated on, or you end up recruiting because that will be incentivized at some point whenever you join. So the next MLM, oh no, this one says one sad and one stupid. Okay. It says, hi Deanna, I love your videos and I've been binging them for weeks. I have thankfully never been victimized by an MLM, but I've watched it happen. For people I know, it works. I've got two stories about it, one sad and one just stupid. First, the sad. My good friend from college, Haley, got married right out of college and a few years later had her first kid. She always wanted to be a wife and a mother, which made it even more tragic that she developed very serious PP, so postpartum depression. It was bad enough that she had to be hospitalized a few times and eventually had to stop working her 9-to-5. The PPD only got worse. Then Haley had her second child, and she also expressed her frustration on Facebook that she'd put on some weight during pregnancy. Cue the huns rushing in to tell her how they could help her lose weight and not be depressed anymore. I remember seeing her progress pictures using those wraps. Surprisingly, it works. Didn't. Haley lost weight through good old diet and exercise. Who would have thunk? When she had her third and final kid during the pandemic, she's still dealing with PPD. It had been a few years since she tried the wraps from It Works. I hope she wouldn't be victimized again, but she's a prime target for MLMs. Not only is she a religious stay-at-home mom, she wants to earn money, and all of them try to convince her that their MLM is the solution for her. During quarantine, she sent me an invite to a virtual party she was hosting for Norwex. I knew what I was getting into, but I told her I'd attend virtually to support her and spent the long hours of the party with the event on mute while I watched TV. Lucky, lucky me. I won the door prize of an amazing dishcloth. I received it in the mail a week later, and it's a dishcloth. But Norwex wasn't done with me yet. Days after the virtual party, Haley messaged me on Facebook, asking me to join her team. I want to support my friend, but I'm not going to do it by encouraging MLM membership. So I said no. The Betherly, I don't know if that's a person, but I'm going to go with it. The Betherly she'd been hosting the party for also contacted me, asking me if I wanted to join now that I knew how amazing the dishcloth was. No thanks. As I was writing this, I checked Haley's Facebook for any more MLM activity, and it looks like she's actively trying to re-enter the legitimate workforce, so I hope MLMs will leave her alone. Now for the stupid story. My boyfriend and I have been together for 7 years, but before we dated, he went on a single date with this girl named Cassie. I'm not sure why she was dating in Pennsylvania when she actively was from Kentucky. Who goes on a date while on a short vacation? I mean, I guess Cassie. Anyway, they only went on a date once. Knowing my boyfriend, Cassie is far too flighty for his taste, and as I said, lived about 700 miles away, but they stayed in contact. I'm not sure when Cassie joined It Works, but unlike Haley, Cassie was all in. Her Instagram was filled with the typical hun post about the free trips, time freedom, working from my phone, and having the best time with my girls, but I was around every time she called my boyfriend, and I heard the real story. Cassie was broke. It Works wasn't her primary job, she was also a CNA, but she was extremely irresponsible with money, and It Works only exacerbated her problems because of all the things she had to buy to keep her business afloat. She'd call my boyfriend asking them for money to pay for her auto ship or help for rent. Once she even asked him to pay for her manicure. She also tried to get him to buy some of the butter keto coffee. Meanwhile, she was shilling out thousands of dollars for the free trips and lying on her Instagram about how she was living debt-free. It was like clockwork. She'd make a gushy It Works post on Instagram, and the same night she called my boyfriend in tears, begging him for money. He never gave her any. Instead, he tried to give her advice. Besides, being aware of Cassie spending money she didn't have, he also knew that Cassie's girls despised her because Cassie told him. She'd send him screenshots of text exchanges between her and her, quote, best friends, unquote, in which they'd straight out call her stupid and worthless because she balked at spending more money or asking a question. They also never let her forget that she was overweight despite using their magic keto coffee every day. My boyfriend, with me in the background, would tell her over and over again to get out of It Works. She'd respond with the usual non-arguments that he was just a hater, he didn't understand, he needed to be more positive. In the middle of the BLM protests last summer, she told my boyfriend, who was black, that he was only a victim of racism because he was too negative and brought it on himself. This was the last straw for him. He blocked her number and all of her accounts on social media. She used several friends' phones and fake social media accounts to try to trick him into talking to her again, but he was not having it. We do know that she left It Works not long after my boyfriend broke off contact with her, but we also knew that she continues to make poor financial and personal decisions. I wouldn't be surprised if she joins another MLM at some point. This stupid story, the whole racism thing, is the most disgusting thing I have freaking heard, and she can go suck my ass is how I feel about that. So I have nothing more to say about the racist Cassie chick besides she's freaking disgusting and can suck my ass, like I've said 5 times. Let's go back to the other story, the sad one. So Haley, being someone who got roped into It Works multiple times, it is really shitty because MLMs like It Works, Beachbody, Thrive, Isagenix, I can literally go on with the amount of wellness MLMs. These MLMs thrive off of mothers, postpartum mothers, postpartum depression, and all of that stuff. And they actively try and recruit these people. And I watch it happen all of the time where people who just had children are being roped into multi-level marketing companies like this because they need to get their pre-baby bod back or something like that. And it's disgusting because no actual professional would ever say that. Like, no actual dietitian or personal trainer, and if they do say that, literally report them and run in the opposite freaking direction. But I have never seen a professional ever say that kind of shit or go after postpartum individuals. Like, never. I've never seen that happen because it's freaking wrong and it is disgusting. And trying to rope someone in to use your wraps that has postpartum depression, these wraps aren't going to help her at all. This person more than likely needs to actually work through that with a professional and not one that is selling her freaking It Works wraps. So let's move on to the next one. This is another It Works one. It says, It Works. works, except it doesn't. Hi, Deanna. My name is Nova, and I've been enjoying watching your channel. Though I've never been in an MLM, I've been surrounded by them to the point where I didn't even know about Pampered Chef, or I didn't even know that Pampered Chef is an MLM until about 6 months ago. My parents have some Cutco knives, my aunt sold Scentsy, and I'm pretty sure my grandma has some Mary Kay products. My horror story is mild compared to many folks. During my freshman year of college, I lost around 30 pounds. Go you! 30 pounds, that's great. Between walking to class and work and going to work out and avoiding eating junk food, skip forward a year, and I felt myself slowly slipping back into my bad habits once I moved into my first apartment with my friends. While scrolling on Facebook, I was used to seeing the occasional MLM post from Hunts, but never really thought about it. One day, when I was having a particularly bad body image day, I noticed a friend posted something along the lines of, "Do any of my friends want their hair to grow 6+ inches or to lose 15 pounds? Comment an emoji below. And my girl Stacy can help you get to your goals." I was intrigued. Stacy and I traded numbers, and she started letting me know about weight loss products. I'm pretty sure she gave me the link to her website. She mentioned wraps, and I immediately knew it was It Works because my ex-girlfriend had worked with them for about 6 months. I wasn't really interested in that. I looked into the keto coffee so I could lose weight though. Bear in mind that I am 20 years old, make a little over $10 an hour, and have to pay my rent and bills myself. I did not have the money to drop $80 on a drink, especially if it only had 2 weeks worth of servings. I'm pretty sure as I was trying to check out, the website told me that I was going to be charged for the item for 3 months as It Works requires auto ship. Yes, that was the final push for me to not get the coffee. Based on your reaction when you tried it, I don't think I missed out on much. So you guys, I did try the It Works products. Their coffee is not my jam. I tried to ghost the hun, and I think eventually just blocked her because I felt bad that I wasted her time. Looking back now, it's kind of funny that I considered buying $80 worth of caffeinated dirt to lose some weight. I haven't bought anything from an MLM distributor, and I plan on keeping it that way. I love that. So yes, that is an actual thing. If you guys have heard of any of my It Works stories that I've shared or any of the times where I've talked about It Works, but yes, they do have like this 3 month auto ship thing. A lot of the times, It Works individuals will get like someone's debit card info and sign them up without them like seeing the actual agreement, and then they'll be stuck with a 3 month auto ship. It's happened, oh my gosh, time and time again where I have literally read stories about this, and I have a friend, like an actual friend who got roped in. An actual friend of mine, let's call her Becky because I don't know if she'd want me to say her name, but Becky one day signed up for It Works, but she only signed up because the It Works rep took Becky's information and put it in herself, and then Becky ended up, I think, getting like weight loss pills or a drink or something, and then the next month Becky got charged again, so she canceled her account, but then was told by It Works that if she canceled, she would still be charged. So she didn't wait, or she waited to cancel until the third month or whatever. But yeah, my friend Becky has been through the same thing, and so have a lot of other people that talk to me about It Works. So I am glad that this person read it. A lot of people don't do that. A lot of people don't read like terms and conditions or things at the end of like when you're checking out. And it's really important to do that with every company, but especially with freaking wholesale marketing companies, because they will be roping you into subscriptions or these monthly things that it says, oh, you have to be in for 3 months and you're, you know, in and you can't get out and you must buy products for 3 months straight in order to get out. So yeah, apparently even if you try and get out, like my friend Becky stayed in because she was going to be charged like a hefty charge in order to leave. So she was just like, fuck it, I might as well just stay in. So yeah, that definitely happens to a lot of people. Let me know if you've ever been in It Works or if you've been like a customer. Has that happened to you? Because I definitely have seen it time and time again. Holy moly, this next story is long. It says, hey Deanna, I have loved listening to your horror stories videos since its inception. This is going to be a very long horror story with 3 parts, including 1, my time in Arbonne, 2, what got me to leave, and 3, the screenshots of the cringe messages I sent friends. Haha. This is going to be very long, but I know you always say you love them, so I hope you and your viewers enjoy. Part 1, how I ended up joining Arbonne. I just finished grad school and was studying for my board exams, and a girl from my sorority recruited me. I had absolute blind faith in this girl because of our prior relationship, but in addition, she graduated with a degree in finance. She was currently working at a major finance firm and the VP of finance at my sorority. All those reasons made me the perfect mark to sign up right after the pitch. I didn't even flinch when I paid the when I paid the $2,100 for product as part of my success plan, and I put it all on my credit card. Holy crap. Long story short, while I made back the initial $2,100 by recruiting 4 people within my first month of joining, I slowly realized it wasn't sustainable, and I was quickly discouraged from all my warm and cold messages I had to do and friends saying no to the business. I ended up moving, which gave me the perfect opportunity to ghost my team, but what ultimately got me to quit Arbonne led me to part two. Part two, how a Nigerian prince scam convinced me to leave Arbonne. It wasn't quite a Nigerian prince, but it was a scam nonetheless. So one day, I get a suspicious email from a complete stranger who wanted to order products. This person claimed she was hard of hearing and had low vision and wasn't great in technology. She wanted to correspond only via email, which is a huge red flag, but desperate to make my Arbonne business work, I wanted to be helpful to this supposed customer who wanted to buy stuff. They didn't trust making payments over the internet and wanted to make me check first, make sure the funds clear, and then I placed the order for her and sent it to their address. They had no interest in the discount and said they would pay full price. Which was also weird and another red flag. But desperate, I went as far as having this person send me a check to my P.O. box and then said they accidentally sent me too much money and they wanted me to deposit the check and then pay them back the difference. At this point, I got freaked out and blocked them. The only information they had of me was my name and P.O. box address and no other identifying information of myself, so I felt safe. But I still put a temporary hold to freeze my credit, etc., just to be safe. After this incident, I quit Arbonne all around. Life update. I carried around so much shame about being in Arbonne, and it made me second guess myself a lot afterwards. It was through watching mainly your videos and other podcasts that helped me heal from it. I am happy to report my life is going well. I'm focusing all my attention on my actual business working with children. Now I'm able to laugh at myself about this brief period of time in my life. Thanks to watching your videos, I feel confident to decline purchasing anything from MLMs as well as decline joining any more in the future. That makes me so freaking happy. And I talk about this a lot, that people who leave MLMs really go through like a whole deprogramming period where you feel a lot of guilt, you feel ashamed, you feel embarrassed that you would even get yourself into a company like this, and how even when you were in the company, you did not realize what was going on. And then you feel shameful that you even reached out to people and believed it. And it could really mess with someone afterwards. And I think we've all been through it. People who are in MLMs that have recruited someone or have sold a product or have even cold messaged someone, when they get out of their MLM, this happens to most people I talk to. So I am glad that you now can like look back and laugh on it and everything like that, because I know how hard it can be to kind of like get to that point. So part three, cringe messages I sent while in Arbonne. Now for part three, enjoy these hilarious and cringe messages I sent to people. A lot of them were repeat info, but I hope you and all the listeners get a good laugh from them. I believe I blocked out all the info to keep it anonymous and make it easier for you. Screenshot 1-3. This was a girl I tried to recruit because she was the stay-at-home mom who wanted to do something, and my upline specifically said, look for stay-at-home moms to join this opportunity. Ugh, so gross. She ended up joining Unique, and then later she tried to recruit me. Side note, what I wrote back to her is a complete lie. Business is terrible. Okay, let's read these. We're gonna call her Sarah. Our friend that sent us this. So Sarah said, long time no talk. I hope you've been well. I love seeing all of the uploaded pictures of baby Brooklyn. I wanted to reach out to you because I saw your Facebook status about looking for work but still want to be a stay-at-home mom. I started a business last year in November called Arbonne, and it has been the best life-changing decision for me. I would love to tell you more about it either over the phone or by Skype. My number is blank. I've attached a quick video to give you some background. If you have any interest in making a sustainable income working less than part-time, I implore you to listen to what I have to say. Oh God, this can change your family's life. And then she links a YouTube video. The person responds with, hey, thank you so much. Wow, it took me forever to write back. I'm grateful for the offer. It's so awesome that you're doing so well with your job. Selling just isn't for me. So I just think I will have to pass. It's nothing personal though. Thanks again. Then the girl writes her again and says, hey, I thought about you today. I know way back when I said that selling wasn't for me, LOL, and then I found something I was comfortable and excited to sell. Are you still selling? I'm looking to train and help people who are experienced in this field. Our girl Sarah says, yes, I'm still working my Arbonne business. I'm glad you found your home with Unique. I'm so happy for you. I'm solid with my business, working with my team and mentors, that I'm not quite sure what it is you're looking to offer. Screenshot 4. This girl I sent a message because I had another friend give me her information. This was in the beginning where I was told if someone doesn't want to join the business, ask them for names of three friends who'd be interested. And she goes, this is me following up. So Sarah says, hey, Kristen, how have you been? I know we haven't spoken in a while, but long story short, I recently started my own business with Arbonne. And I was talking to Blank the other day, and she told me that one, you've heard of it, and two, you were running out of products and was looking to reorder some. Anyway, not sure if this isn't the entire story, but if you are looking to purchase more products, feel free to give me a call at Blank, and I'd be happy to walk you through how you can place another online order. Hope you have a great day. Screenshot 5. This is a text thread with my sister. The first one is her responding to my Facebook status that probably said something like boss babe or business is booming, and my sister saying that my mom is my best customer. Notice how defensive I was. I am happy to report I never recruited my mom nor had her buy the product. So the sister goes, also, LOL at your status. I want to comment, quote, killing it because your mom is your primary customer, but I resisted. Sarah goes, mom only wants me to send her free samples. She doesn't want to buy shit. She just wants free perks. Her sister goes, lie. Sarah goes, mom has bought nothing. I can see it on the website. She hasn't even signed up. Screenshot 6, a conversation between my sister and I. I think it speaks for itself. Okay, so sister goes, yo, my iPhone case is dying. Any suggestion for a new one? Sarah goes, how do you like the Arbonne products? Sister goes, dot, dot. Sarah goes, I just want to know, and I don't know for cases. Go to Society 8. Oh my gosh. Screenshot 7. This is what I sent to my best friend from college, and I'm so grateful that we are still friends despite this and many other cringe messages I sent to her like this. Ugh. So Sarah goes, hope you had a good day. I know I keep asking you, but are you ready to start your business with me? If you have a moment, listen to this recording from my business partner. She talks about everything that I have talked about with you about my Arbonne biz. I would love nothing more than to share this opportunity with you and be, oh no, and together become millionaires. Call me. Screenshot 8. This is a long message I sent to a girl who was someone's acquaintance that came to me of my, oh wait, that came to one of my Discover Arbonne events. Poor girl. Read on for more cringe. Sarah goes, blank. I wanted to thank you so much for coming out to New Haven today and listening to the Arbonne opportunity. I was really excited to see your energy and enthusiasm in potentially starting your own Arbonne business. I know you voiced your concerns, including not having a credit card and wanting to focus on school, which I completely understand. These are easy solutions when you look at the big picture. We can get you a credit card in seconds, and I will make sure you make your money back. What's amazing about Arbonne is that you can tailor your work with Arbonne around the scheduled... Oh, around your schedule and your needs. I understand school is most important to you and that can still be a priority. Your schoolwork does not have to suffer with Arbonne. Every day is different and you work Arbonne in the cracks of your day. Imagine yourself making money while you're studying for an exam or taking a test because you connected a friend, family member, or an acquaintance to the Arbonne brand. And they are freely shopping without you having to be there. That would be amazing. Please do consider these possibilities and think about the opportunities that Arbonne can offer you. I sincerely hope to hear from you soon. Please do not hesitate to call me if you have any questions. I saw your eyes light up throughout the presentation today, and I believe you see the potential in yourself to make Arbonne a success for you. Think about your why and how you can change your life today. Have a great day. It was a pleasure meeting you. And the last screenshot says, this is a message between a friend's sister who is already in Arbonne. Notice how she writes, I wish I recruited you. Gag. So the person said, of course, I remember you from the graduation party. I love Arbonne and the lady selling it in my area. We have a lot of fun at meetings and parties. I've been a consultant for a little over a year now, and I find that I prefer a more laid-back style, so I'm selling casually to family and friends. I think you'd be great at selling Arbonne. I wish I recruited you. Haha. You'll be moving up in no time. Also, I love the Learn and Burns. They are very good and easy to listen to in the car. Oh gosh. Yeah, this happens a lot. Like, the thing with being in an MLM is you are always technically competing against every other person that's in the MLM, which is why we always talk about saturation and multi-level marketing companies being oversaturated, because literally everyone knows everyone. Like, you will know a friend that's in Arbonne, or you know a family member that's in the MLM, or you've been reached out to before by someone. Like, a lot of people have been connected to an MLM in some way, shape, or form, even if they don't recognize it. So like, this chick wishes she would have recruited. Instead of being like, I'm so happy you're in Arbonne, I hope you and your upline are doing great. She goes, I wish I recruited you. I wish I recruited you because I bet you're good at selling. Meaning, I wish that I got to you first, not the other chicks, that I could be the one making money off of you. Yikes. So she ended with, I hope you enjoyed these cringeworthy screenshots. Lots of love all the way from Japan. Oh yeah, that's where I live right now. That one, I've never had anyone share like their actual MLM posts or like their actual MLM text messages. I've had people share text messages, like blurring out the names and everything like that, and kind of just showing examples of what other people have said to them that were in MLM, but I have never had this. So thank you so much for sharing your story with me. And again, I am so freaking happy that you got out of the MLM and that videos like mine and others and podcasts, which is why it's so amazing that there's so many different platforms where there are individuals, you know, having commentary on MLM or just talking about MLMs. So that makes me really happy to know that some of those things could help you kind of get through the guilt period and that you were even comfortable sharing screenshots. I know a lot of people are not even comfortable themselves going back and looking at their own posts. They'll normally just ignore it or like go back and delete them really quickly because they're so ashamed just to look at their own messages. Kudos to you for even sending this to me. So that's going to be all for today's video. Don't forget to leave a like and a comment. I would love to know what you guys thought about today's and also about the last story. Very interested in that. And then don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I will see you guys in Monday's video.